This study tracked about 1,000 adults in the United States, and they ranged in age from 34 to 93, and they started the study by asking, how much stress have you experienced in the last year? They are also asked, how much time have you spent helping out friends, neighbors, people in your community? And then they used public records for the next 5 years to find out who died. Cheerful sunny yellow is an attention getter. While it is considered an optimistic color, people lose their tempers more often in yellow rooms, and babies will cry more. It is the most difficult color for the eye to take in, so it can be overpowering if overused. Yellow enhances concentration, hence its use for legal pads. It also speeds metabolism. The provision of accurate and authoritative statistical information strengthens modern societies. It provides a basis for decisions to be made on such things as where to open schools and hospitals, how much money to spend on welfare payments, and even which football players to replace at halftime. Hundreds of millions of people buy fast food every day without giving it much thought, unaware of the subtle and not so subtle ramifications of their purchases. They just grasp a hamburger and unwrap it and toss the wrap into the bin. The whole experience is transitory and soon forgotten. The border itself between Mexico and United States is fraught with a mix of urban and desert terrain and spans over 1,900 miles. Both the uninhabited areas of the border and urban areas are where the most drug trafficking and illegal crossings take place. Crime is prevalent in urban cities like El Paso, Texas, and San Diego, California. Some people object that in order for the eye to modify and still remain a useful instrument to its owner, many changes would have had to take place simultaneously. However, it is not necessary to suppose this if the modifications were extremely slight and gradual. Intangible assets perform a number of distinctive functions in the life of each company. Firstly, they witness the prosperity of the firm and its good name. Such a position allows human resource management to employ professional workers and increase the labor productivity. Moreover, intangible assets guarantee future value for the firm. And although it is difficult to destroy intangible assets, they can lose their importance in case of carelessness or business failure. Therefore, the working unions in modern society are not very important. They preserve their functions only in the underdeveloped countries. On the contrary, in the developed states, workers refuse to join the unions, preferring individual work. Thus, working unions cannot survive the assault of modern economic trends and slowly move to a complete decline. Their initial purposes have little to do with the hectic pace of modern life. Writers may make the mistake of making all their sentences too compact. Some have made this accusation against the prose of Gibbon. An occasional loose sentence prevents the style from becoming too formal and allows the reader to relax slightly. Loose sentences are common in easy, unforced writing, but it is a fault when there are too many of them. A university is not a business. More precisely, a not-for-profit college or university is significantly different than a for-profit business. A university has no owners, it is a public trust. Without owners, it has no one to pay dividends to, and no one for whom it must maximize its profits. A business has a single overriding goal, the maximization of return for the owners. A university has a multiplicity of goals, to foster learning, to create knowledge, and to serve its community. Yellow is considered as the most optimistic color, yet surprisingly, people lose their tempers most often in yellow rooms and babies will cry more. The reason may be that yellow is the hardest color for eyes to take in, so it can be overpowering if overused. As to the Industrial Revolution, one cannot dispute today the fact that it has succeeded in inaugurating in a number of countries a level of mass prosperity which was undreamt of in the days preceding the Industrial Revolution. But, on the immediate impact of Industrial Revolution, there were substantial divergences among writers. Thompson recognized and exploited all the ingredients of a successful amusement ride, writes Judith Adams in the American Amusement Park Industry. His coasters combined an appearance of danger with actual safety, thrilled riders with exhilarating speed, and allowed the public to intimately experience the Industrial Revolution's new technologies of gears, steel, and dazzling electric lights. See Northcote Parkinson, a British writer, formulated Parkinson's rule, work expands to fill the time allotted to it, or, conversely, the amount of work completed is in inverse proportion to the number of people employed. Simply said, if you have an hour to do a 5-minute job, it will take an hour to do it. A large number of people accomplish less work than a smaller number of people. When countries assess their annual carbon dioxide emissions, they count up their cars and power stations, but bushfires are not included, presumably because they are deemed to be events beyond human control. In Australia, Victoria alone sees several hundred thousand hectares burn each year. In both 2004 and the present summer, the figure has been over 1 million hectares. The college has a fascinating museum dedicated to archaeology and anthropology. It contains information about many of the studies which have been carried out by members of the college over the 500 years of its existence. There are many unique exhibits brought back from excavations and explorations in all the continents. In the Middle Ages, the design and use of flags were considered a means of identifying social status. Flags were, therefore, the symbols not of nations, but of the nobility. The design of each flag resembled the devices on the noble's coat of arms, and the size of the flags was an indication of how high the owner stood in the nobility.